Did you know you can store your bank statements, credit card statements, loan documents, and any other balance sheet account statements in QuickBooks Online? Stick around and I'll show you how to do this in three easy steps. Thank you for supporting our channel. For those of you that are new here, I am Ufama Ogaga, a financial controller and a workflow efficiency advisor to nonprofit organizations. Today's video is all about storing your account statements in QuickBooks Online. This option is excellent if you have multiple people using different cloud storage systems. And if you want to keep your source documents linked to the account reconciliation process in QuickBooks Online, this option allows you to give your external accounting professionals, such as your tax preparers and your auditors, access to your balance sheet account documents. Finally, this step should be done as part of your document and retention process to ensure your organization has the redundancy backup of your source documents in QuickBooks Online. To get started, we need to create a generic vendor name called Account Statements. So click Expenses, then select Vendors to open the Vendor Center. Note that Intuit is changing the left navigation panel, so find whichever option that leads you to the Vendor Center in your QuickBooks Online file. Click the new Vendor Green button to open the Vendor Creation pop-up window. Add Account Statements in all caps in the company name field. You will see that the name automatically shows in the display name field and in the name to print on the checks field. We're making the name all caps so someone can know that this is a generic vendor and not a real one to group and house all of the statements we will add to QuickBooks Online. Scroll down to where it says notes and attachments. Add a note in the notes field that says, this vendor is used to house various balance sheet account statements. Then click Save to exit the vendor creation screen. Next, if you don't already have this, you need to create a bank type clearing account called Journal in your charts of accounts. The journal account is meant for you to use to house various movements of funds between balance sheet accounts and make it easy to find a list of your journal entries throughout the year. Click Accounting and select Charts of Accounts. Here's my journal account. You can click on the new button to create a new account if you don't already have this. Next, we will create a zero-sum expense transaction using the expense form. There is no monetary value assigned to this transaction. Therefore, it has zero effect on your finances in QuickBooks Online. In my example, I'll be using this Bank of America credit card statement to record the expense transaction. So click on the plus new menu. Under the Vendors column, select the Expense form. Find the Account Statements vendor we created earlier in the Payee field. Then for the Payment account, select the Journal account. The payment date should be the statement ending date. Keep the payment method blank. The Reference Number field should be the short abbreviated account name plus the acronym for statement and the statement ending date. For example, BOASTMT01-27-17. The category should be the actual account that you are reconciling. For example, this is the Bank of America credit card statement account. The description field should say the month and the year of the statement with a small note that says see the attachment field. The amount is zero and the class is just management in general. You're going to leave the billable and the customer field blank. Copy the description from the top and put it in the memo box. And drag and drop your account statement into the attachment field. Review all your work before hitting the save and close button. When you reconcile the accounts at the end of the statement closing period, you will select this zero sum expense transaction in the reconciliation window. If you need QuickBooks Online training or accounting services for your nonprofit organization, feel free to message us using the email address in the description box or directly message us wherever you're watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video to help us grow our community.